welcome you all in the presence of Jehovah today, even as we welcome them that are watching us through online. May the Lord God bless you in the name of Jesus. Even as we start our service today, we ask you to join with us, even as we prepare to worship the Lord, to give him praise for who he is, for he is faithful, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. To pray even as we start our service in Jesus' mighty name. Let us pray. Loving Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We give you praise and we give you honor. We acknowledge of your faithfulness. We acknowledge of your goodness. We acknowledge of your lordship over our lives. Father, you are God by yourself, and you need no one to make you God. We thank you because you remain faithful. We thank you for yet another opportunity to be found in your holy presence. Father, we don't take this chance for granted. We know, Father, that many wanted and wished to be here today and even to see a new day, but they did not make it, oh God. But I thank you because we didn't give anything for us to see this day, but your grace, your mercy, that has been new upon each and every one of us. We give you praise and we honor you, Jehovah. Thank you for the sound mind. Thank you for the breath of life. Thank you for the hearing grace upon us, O God. We bless and exalt your holy name. We declare of your faithfulness and of your grace upon our lives. We are nothing without you, O God. We acknowledge the presence of the Holy Spirit in our midst. We acknowledge that you are omnipresent, present here right now in the name of Jesus. We call you Shammah, for you are here with us in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Even as we start our service today, we pray that you will have your way, be the Alpha and the Omega in the name of Jesus Christ. Even as we open our mouth and worship and exalt your holy name, even as we seek to hear from you, O God, for you have anointed and prepared your servant, Holy Diva, to speak your oracles in our lives. We thank you because this day, O God, our lives are going to be transformed, O God. Our lives are no longer being the same. In the name of Jesus Christ, we give you praise and honor, O God. We are expected from you in the name of Jesus Christ. May you have your way, O God. Even unto our viewers, O Lord, have your way. Have your way. Holy Spirit of God, have your way. Come and change lives. Come and touch lives. Come and have your way. Thank you for your peace that surpasses human understanding. Thank you for your presence. Lord, we want to acknowledge, even in such a moment, even in such a season, oh, our hearts are full of gratitude because you have done great things, Lord. We give you praise. We acknowledge you as a man of war, fighting our battles each and every single day. We see your faithfulness in our lives. When we go out and come in, we see your promises being fulfilled in our lives. We call you man of war. You're fighting our battles. We thank you. Have your way. Have your way. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
as we worship, as we praise the Lord with a hammer in Jesus' mighty name. Join us as we praise Him with a hammer in Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And I promise you, you will hear from Jesus.
Amen.
He will speak even as he used his servant. So without much ado, I want you to join me even at home there. Join us as we welcome the servant of the Most High God, our senior pastor, Pastor Samuel Mutuku, as he comes to share the word of God. Hallelujah.
Appreciate the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. So we
chapter number 43. You will go together with me if you are already there. Amen. I want to start from verse number 13. Yeah. Before the day was, I am he. And there is none that can deliver out of my hand. I will work, and who shall let it? Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sake I have sent to Babylon, and have brought down all their nobles, and the Chaldeans, whose cry is in the ships. Number 15. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus says the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters, which bringeth forth the chariot and horse, and the army and the power. They shall lie down together, they shall not rise, they are extinct, they are quenched as fire. Number 18, which is the message, which is the verse of our message today. Remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Number 19, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the deserts. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now I want to thank God because of his word. And this is the word that God wants to encourage us with even today. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now the Bible is saying clearly that God is in, is our creator. Amen. And he's saying, before the day was, I am he, and there is none that can deliver out of my hand. And I want to say to the church and to the church of Jesus that we want to thank God because of his creative power in our lives and the ability of our God to do new things in our lives. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God is a creator. God is always in the business of doing new things in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God does not want our lives to remain stale, to waste away, and to live as though there is nothing new that is happening in our lives. So he's introducing himself in this scripture and he's saying, I am he. And before even the day was, I was. And no one can deliver from my hand. Because the hand of the Lord is mighty. The hand of the Lord is a creative hand. The hand of the Lord is the only hand that is able to do new things in our life. And as I was preparing this, sermon, I heard the Spirit of the Lord, just speak to my life and tell me that embrace the new thing. Child of God, embrace the new thing. God is in the business. He is in your life doing a new thing. Amen. And why is God doing a new thing in our lives? God is doing a new thing in our lives because a lot of us have come to the end of our roads. A lot of us have come to the end of something that we were used to. Life in itself is just changed. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are not living the way we used to live. We are not doing things. We are not conducting ourselves the way we used to conduct ourselves. And it does not mean because, things, the way you used to do things is like, now your life has come to an end. God is saying to us today, Church of Jesus, that there is a new thing that he wants to do. Hallelujah. There is a new thing that God wants to do into our lives. And it is upon each child of God to embrace that new thing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is something new, and it comes out of the realization and the belief and the understanding that our God is a God of new beginnings. There is always something that he wants to do to our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Even you, from wherever you are watching us and hearing us, today is a new day. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We are not living yesterday. We are not on Saturday. Today is called Sunday. Why? Because God is always giving us a new day. A new day to see new things. A new day to embrace new things. A new day to live our lives differently. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So our God is the creator. When you read the book of Genesis chapter number 1, just verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. So it is God who is creating things in our lives. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he says in the scriptures that we have read, he is going to create a new thing. And he is challenging me and you to forget the former things.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, a lot of us, probably even as believers, and even as ordinary people, we hold so much to the old ways. We cling to things as they used to be. We are used to, our children going to school. Now they have been with us for over 100 days. And we are anxious, we don't know what will happen to our children. And you are waiting for what used to be to return. And I want to boldly say to us that it may not be the old that is coming, but it is the new that we must embrace. Hallelujah. There are things that I used to do. There are things that you used to do. And they brought joy. They brought satisfaction. And they brought fulfillment. And there was profit in those things that I used to do. And all of a sudden, there is a pandemic. And the way of life has been, you know, turned upside down. Is this the end of life? And I want to say to us in Jesus' mighty name, it is not the end of life. It is not the end of your situation. It is not the end of the education of your children. It is not the end of your business. It is not the end of your profitability. God, who is the creator, he is telling us from all over the world that he is in the business of creating and is doing a new thing in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse number 16, the Bible says, thus says the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters. I want to speak to our lives this morning, Church of Jesus, that there is something that you have been holding on to. And let me tell you, I speak this because I know I have been affected, I have been, in one way impacted, and life has basically changed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And while we are probably at the 100 and something day of this pandemic, there is someone who has been waiting for normalcy to return. You are waiting for normal things to come back, you know, the way you used to know them. And every day as we hear of the reports worldwide, that, oh yes, economies open up and close again. You know, things open up and they close again. Then you wonder when and how will we, you know, continue in this? For how long will it take? And you are still clinging to your old self. Clinging to the things that brought profit to your life. But God is speaking to each one of us this day. And he's saying you can turn around. You can turn around and see the new thing that I want to do into your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are a parent at home and you're wondering, when will my, you know, child go back, because I need him in the next grade. Now the truth could be the opposite, that probably we could be around with our children for a longer period. Now that is not the end of their education. But the Lord is saying, embrace the new thing. You can look at your family and afresh and say, there are talents and skills that these children can learn. And there are things that can come out of my children so that the next thing they are in school and the next time they are in school, they will have acquired talents. They will have acquired skills. They will have known the Lord in a better way. There is a new thing that God is doing in our families. There is a new way of worship that God is bringing our way. Personalizing worship and making it a personal decision for each one of us to praise and to worship him. Corporate, yes, we loved it. We loved it when we sang in the choir. We loved it when we could come together, and even just being together was, you know, good and consolation and uplifting and social welfare of each other. But what do we do when this doesn't happen? Hallelujah. Embrace the new thing. Hallelujah. Embrace the new thing. That is the message. Embrace the new thing that God is doing in your life and in my life. Yes, that work that you used to do, probably you've been told, probably wait a little bit. We will call you, probably you're being told, probably then we will see whether you will continue working. And this has affected us. True, it has affected us. But I want to assure you, it is not the end of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is not the end of life. And especially for the believer in God, home. He that created that family and gave you that wonderful family and gave you that wonderful business, He is God and His name is the Creator, and He wants you to believe in Him that He is doing a new thing. He wants to give you a new direction in life. He wants to give you a new pursuit in your life that is also profitable. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, a lot of things are bound to change, and they will change. Probably the way we did, and theology and what has been taught to man has a way of reaching God is being challenged by this situation called COVID-19. And there are theologies upon theologies and man's way of reaching God that probably will be challenged and we will forget them for good. Hallelujah. We will forget them for good because they were man's way of reaching God. They were man's way of teaching another man on how to reach God. But God has always insisted that this one is my only way that you can reach me and you can believe in me and you can hear me. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I say this because, you know, we have all sorts of faith in the world today. Some believe you have to touch things. Some believe you have to bow to things so that then God sees your worship. Now embrace the new. That is like done. That is now going past. That is slowly going to be forgotten. And God is saying, I want you to believe in me, believe in my word, believe in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. And what I say in my word will be created in you by the Holy Spirit. And so please embrace the new thing that I am doing in your life. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now, this is what the Bible says. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? Now that is the challenge, child of God. And this is the message, and this is the word that is coming to all of us from the word of God. God is doing a new thing. And I can say this a million times, and I can say it again and again. But the challenge to the child of God is, shall you not know it? You know, as you whine and as you murmur and as you complain, all things have dried up, my life has changed, I'm not moving on. Oh, and it is true, those are facts of life, and we can see them, and we know that is what is happening. But our God is asking each one of us, will you not know the new thing that I am doing? Hallelujah. I have had testimonies, and testimonies are everywhere, that God is doing a new thing everywhere. I have seen people getting new business ideas. I have seen people who are now did not embrace technology. They are right now into technology, and technology has become their new environment. God is simply saying, there is something that I am doing in your life. You may not, you know, you may not understand, but I know I need you to begin to seek to know it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are clinging to your past. Oh, I used to be this way. Oh, I used to do this. And it is very fun even in the Church of Jesus. Hallelujah, believers. You know, some say, until I bring the offering to the offering basket, I have not given. You are still clinging to your old. Until I bring it to the church, I cannot just send it online. What is this online? You know? And there are people who just believe I need to bring it to a basket, and then that will be called an offering. Please forget the former things. Embrace the new. Things have changed. God can receive your offering even through the phone and through those channels that have been provided, because things have changed. And as a child of God, you need to begin to say, I will worship God even if I am not present in the altar of the Lord. I will still do the things that that the word of God commands me to do, because I still believe God receives my offerings. He receives my tithes. I will do what I must do as a believer, because what I do as a believer is what will open my eyes to see the new thing that God is doing in my life. Hallelujah. So we are praying this morning, and we are asking the Lord, may the Lord open our eyes. May the Lord open your eyes. You are in a difficult situation, yes. You have come to your age. You don't know what is happening and what will happen tomorrow. And let me tell you, from the first day of this pandemic to now, what it is, we keep seeing rising cases, and it's like we are moving from a green place to the desert place. Now listen to what the Bible is saying. The Bible is saying, "You shall I will even make a way in the wilderness." A lot of us now are getting into the wilderness experience. Yes, yesterday you had a few resources. The other month you had a few resources. But now as we get, you know, as things get tightier, and as things get, you know, seemingly worse in the eyes of men, you are beginning to say, "Oh my, I am getting into the wilderness." I want to tell you in the mighty name of Jesus, and submit this word of God into your life. Yes, you are seeing a wilderness. You are seeing things becoming worse. But God, who is the creator, is saying, "I will make a way in the wilderness." He is going to make a way in your wilderness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. A child of God, just come and begin to say, "I will believe in God. I will believe in what He is saying in this time. I will not shrink in this season." The Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter number 30, verse 5, or 4, 5, right there, that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I wish you are listening to the Spirit of God, and He is saying in your life, yes, you have come to the end. The business is closed and nothing is happening. But listen, if you will see God, God is saying, "I need people to begin to see me, to begin to know that I am doing a new thing in their lives. It is not the end of our children. It is not the end of their education. It is not the end of our economies. It is God is standing up, and things are around, and there is a new thing that God is doing. There is a wilderness, yes. Yesterday I had money, today I don't have money. But I want to tell you in the mighty name of Jesus that God is making a way, and He's asking the believer, "Shall you not know it? Shall you not know the way that I am making in your way?" How do we know the way? We will seek the face of God. We will go up to the mountain. We will go back to our Creator, and we will tell Him, "God, you created me. You gave me this first job. You gave me this first business, and it is coming to an end. But I need you now. I want to know the new thing that you are doing in my life, in the mighty name of Jesus." Hallelujah. Embrace the new thing. Shall you not know it? And instead of getting into the counsel of the wicked and to the scornful and those who are saying, "Oh, God has forgotten us," let me tell you, child of God, God has not forgotten His own. God has not forgotten His own. There is something that He is gonna do. The Bible says in the book of Lamentations, chapter number 3, from verse 23 and 24. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The mercies of God are new every morning, and because of His mercies we are not consumed. You are not going to be consumed by the power of this word. I speak to your situation this day that you are not going to be consumed. The Lord who created you in His likeness and in His image, He's going to ensure that you are going to survive. Not just to survive, we are living to live and to lead men, because our God is a faithful God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is making a way in the wilderness in Jesus' name. And He is making rivers in the desert. Let me tell you, nobody understands your situation more than God. God understands you have come to the end. God understands that you have come to the end of yourself. He knows that this sister now cannot even afford food. They cannot afford rent. They cannot even do anything. He knows the desert situation in your life. And He is saying, "I will make rivers." Hallelujah. He will make rivers in the desert. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse number 20, the Bible says, "The beast of the field shall honor me, The dragon shall and the owls, because I give waters in the wilderness and rivers in the desert to give drink to my people, my chosen. These people have I formed for myself. They shall show forth my praise. Hallelujah. We will not die but live to declare the works of our living God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, I don't know if you want to challenge yourself as we come to the close of this preaching to forget. There at home, we have very good memories of a good business. Oh, how can I forget, servant of God? I have this experience and now it's cut off. How can I forget? Hallelujah. How do I forget? Psalms chapter 40. Let's just read Psalms chapter 40. Embrace a new thing. Then it is time to look at the works and to look at your hands and say, from these hands there is profit. From these hands there is a new business idea. From these hands there is something that I can do that will profit me and will come from the Lord, giving me a new beginning from these hands. It's no longer, you know, your employer or your past or what you used to do. It is what God is bringing your way, because He knows you are well able and equipped to do those things. Amen. Psalms number 40, I will just read quickly. The psalmist says, I waited patiently for the Lord, and He inclined unto me, and He heard my cry. May the Lord hear your cry. Amen. You have come to the end. You are in a desert situation. You're asking, where will the water come from? May God hear your cry. Amen. And now the reason why we don't see God and the new things He's doing, because we are not found in the place of crying, in the place of prayer, in the place of calling upon Him. Now David says, I waited patiently. A lot of us are waiting upon God so that our children may get back to school and things may come back. They may come back, but in a new way. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. And He heard my cry. He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock and established my goings. Hallelujah. Rise up from wherever you are in the name of Jesus. I speak rising up from wherever you are in the name of Jesus, that God may establish your going. A lot of us, the reason why we have to sit there and just whine on the past is because we do not want to rise up. You do not want to take a step of faith and say, I hear the Lord leading me in this direction. You just want to clean and to cry over the past. The Lord is saying, He will establish the goings that we will make when we take a step of faith. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Be like the lepers who say, yes, there is famine in the city. We are lepers, we have been quarantined. And there is no hope for us. And even if we go to the camp of the enemy, we will die. Then they will kill us. But they say, nevertheless, even if we say we sit here, we will die anyway. So they say, let's rise up. Let me tell you, my brother, my sister, my friend, as you choose to embrace the new, God is going to establish your going. You will look at something that you are beginning to do and say, hey, I didn't know the Lord was involved in this. I didn't know I could become a businessman. I didn't know I could bake cakes and then I have orders. I didn't know that my child can play chess and the next thing we are moving to a new house. I saw that and I say, my, hallelujah. Because this is what the Lord does. When you believe in Him, when you cry and wait upon Him, He will establish your goal. There is something, there is a direction that the Lord will tell you, take this. And when you take that direction,
He will establish you again.
Amen? Amen.
He will take you out of your horrible pit. The truth is, a lot of us are in that horrible pit. But is that the end of our lives? No. There is a lifting up, and that is why for us, even as a fellowship in the next 7 days, we are going to cry out to God. We are going to lift up our eyes to God, and we are going to tell Him, Heavenly Father, we want a lifting up because we are not remaining here in this horrible pit. I pray that in Jesus' name, you will not remain in that horrible pit, that the Lord will pluck you out. You will begin to say, He is establishing my goals. I am beginning to see something new. I am beginning to see the work of my children. I am beginning to see talent in them. I am beginning to see love in the family. I am beginning to worship God in a personal way, even in a better way than, you know, when we did it corporately. Hallelujah. Now, what next is going to happen? Number three, listen to this word. He shall put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear and shall trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. I say you are the next miracle that is waiting to happen in Jesus' name. And a new song shall be put in your mouth. We don't sing new songs just because they have come. New songs are born out of a new experience. I pray that in the name of Jesus, there will be in your life a new experience. You will sing a new song. Oh, God is good. His mercies endure forever. I didn't know I can be a carpenter. I didn't know I could be this and the other. God is putting a new song in each one of us as we begin to say, I am coming out of the horrible pit. In Jesus' name. There is a new song that you must see. Hallelujah. And the Bible says men shall see it. Men shall see what God is doing in your life. Some are waiting for your downfall. Some are saying she used to drive and now she's selling the car. They're saying, oh, probably you have here property. And now the property is gone because of the pandemic. Listen to me. There is coming your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, there is coming our way. A new song and men shall see what the Lord is doing in our life. And what shall they do? The Bible says, and they shall trust in the Lord. Amen. Be the reason, you and myself, be the reason why your neighbor will say, I will trust in God. I have seen Him in my brother right here. I have seen Him in my sister right here. Oh, I thought we were sinking, but I have seen God in my brother and my sister, and I will embrace the new thing that God is doing. Church of Jesus, we may not go back to the normal things and ways of doing things, but one of the things I know is that God is creating to us better, powerful. I hear revival. Revival in a new way. Revival in all the ways of worship. God is doing a new thing in our midst. There will be songs of deliverance. You will serve the Lord. You will be an ambassador where you are, because God is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to read number five as we just, we close many times. Amen. Five. Blessed is the man that maketh the Lord his trust, that we have talked about. Number five says, many. Hallelujah. Because he's our creator. I want to let you know. Many, many, many. Oh Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works. And you are saying, servant of God, I believe in this job. I believe this will be my stay. It was my passion. But many, I want to assure you, child of God. The Bible says, oh Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works. They are not few. God is not short of giving us good things, works. He can change your situation and change you to anything because his works are many. Hallelujah. Which thou hast done, and thou thoughts which are towards us, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto me. If I would declare and speak of them, they are more than can be numbered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Number six, the Bible says, sacrifice and offering thou did not desire. My ears, as thou opened, burnt offerings and sin offerings has thou not required. But number 7 is very important. Psalms number 40 and verse 7. I love this scripture. Then say I, Lord, I come. In the volume of the book it is written of me. In the volume of the book it is written of me. If I am going to believe for good and new things in my life, I must believe that it is written in the word of God. If I have to, you know, to if God has to establish my goals, I must believe as a child of God that in the volume of the word of God, everything that you ever needed, everything that you wanted to become is written in the word of God. And in the volume of the book of the Almighty God is written about the many works, is written about the many thoughts that he has towards you. Amen. You and me are limited. Oh, just a kiosk. And maybe in God's volume, it's a supermarket. Hallelujah. You are saying, I'm Kenyan and I will die probably in Kenya, in the village or wherever you are. God is saying you will be a legislator in Australia. Now think about that. You are seeing Kangemi Limited buying mandazi and eating mandazi. God is saying, I'm seeing an American in the next 20 years. His words, his thoughts are many towards us. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to read 1 Corinthians chapter 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Embrace the new. I wish it was the days of the church when we used to say, turn to your neighbor. Yeah, probably there at home, turn to your neighbor and tell them, embrace the new. Yes, don't die stale. You are not old. God does not, you know, keep himself in the old stuff. He is doing a new thing. And even in the body of Christ, he is doing a new thing. Amen. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 2. How does he make us know the new thing that he is doing? How will you know? And that is where now a lot of people will see God doing things in your life when they are stuck in their old. Chapter 2, number 7, as we come to the close. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom of God, which God ordained before the world unto our glory. So we speak what God says about us, not what the current situation speaks about us. The Bible says we speak what God said before the foundation of the world, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would have not crucified the Lord of glory. Man number 9, and I love these scriptures. But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. It is not yet known. It has not entered into the ear of any man. It has not entered into the heart of any man. The things that God is preparing for your life. I see you in the future and you are better than now. I see you in the future and you are healed in the name of Jesus. I see you in the future and you are better than this situation. I see your children in the future and they are the great leaders of this nation in the name of Jesus. Because no ear has heard what they have become, what God has prepared in store for them that love him. Hallelujah. Number 10, the Bible is giving me now the joy of salvation. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes you go to the leader and to our leaders, and actually, honestly, leaders all over the world, let me tell you this, they are overwhelmed. They want to know what the scientists are saying. They are asking, can we open? Can we lock? What is going to happen? Can we go back to school? And nobody has those answers. But as a child of God, verse 10 says, but God has revealed them to us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of a man which is in him? Even so, the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. Now, hallelujah. Say now. Not yesterday, now. Now, hallelujah. We have received not the spirit of the world. Let me tell you, the spirit of the world speaks defeat. The spirit of the world speaks impossibilities. But the spirit which is in us, the same spirit that resurrected Jesus from the dead, the powerful spirit of God speaks new beginnings. Hallelujah. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. I end this telecast by telling you, you can invite the Holy Ghost in your life, and you can go to the prayer closet, and you will begin to hear the spirit of God telling you, the Lord is giving you freely. The world will not give you anything freely. The world will not give you a business freely, but God is saying, when I drop this idea into your spirit, when I drop it into your mind, it will sprout and nothing will hinder it, because I am the God who creates new things. The power of God will be behind the idea. The power of God will be behind every step that you are going to make as a child of God, and your life will get about time, a shift, and you'll begin to see new things. And so I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, my brother, my sister, my friend, embrace the new. Embrace the new. Embrace the new. I know wearing a mask and I know all these other things. Sometimes you are saying, oh my, I don't like this. God, you know, why are you taking us through this stuff? Let me tell you, it is a good experience. It is a good experience. Hallelujah. It is a good experience to wash our hands. It is a good experience. It is very healthy. Hallelujah. I think even after this, we'll just continue doing these things because they are good. They are not bad. They are good for our health. But I am concerned about the new thing that God is going to do into your life. God is going to give you a new business. He is going to bring an idea to your life that will make you move forward. He will establish your voice, and your life will never be the same in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me pray with you in Jesus' name. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you because of your word. We thank you because you have given us an opportunity to hear your word that is in the book of Isaiah 48, Lord, from verse 13. That, Lord, you are saying, yes, you understand that we are going through desert situations and rivers, and our lives have run dry. Father, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, because you gave me this word, and you gave me this word for my friend who is listening, Lord. I pray that in the name of Jesus, that we will begin to embrace the new. We will begin to worship you anyhow, anywhere, where we are, in our places, of work, in our businesses, in our homes, Jehovah God. We will not refuse to call on you because things have stopped. The normal way of things have stopped, oh God. But Father, I pray that Jehovah God, even as the church that was born at Calvary by the shedding blood of Jesus Christ, Lord, I pray that we'll embrace the new thing that you are doing in our lives as believers, as you prepare us for the second coming of our Lord Jesus. Father, I pray for my brother and my sister that, Lord, there will be new beginnings. There will be new things happening in their lives, beginning now, as they begin to listen to the Spirit, as they begin to believe in your word. My God, because the Bible says in the volume of your book, oh, it is written about us, oh God. May what is written about my sister come to pass. May what is written about my brother come to pass. There is healing in the volume of your book. There is deliverance in the volume of your book. There is victory and great breakthroughs in the volume of your book. Let it come to pass in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you praise, O Jehovah God. I thank you, my Father. Even as your servant, I release grace to every believer that is going to pick up this word and go up the mountain and seek you, because they have come to a wilderness experience, Lord. Father, I pray that they will see. It is very difficult to have a way in the desert place. But Lord, I pray that there will be a way. There will be a way for my brother. There will be springs of water in the rivers that have dried up. By grace, Jehovah God, and by the obedience of this word, it shall be so in our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you and I give you praise for your wonderful and worthy to be praised. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Let's put our hands together.